In this little video, we are going to look at compensation again and do a little critique of that, and also relate compensation to consumer surplus that we developed when we studied supply and demand. So we're going to develop two different concepts. One's called the compensating variation, which is the income to get back to the original indifference curve at new prices, and the equivalent variation, which is the income change to get to the new indifference curve, but at the old prices. Those are not necessarily the same. And then we will relate this in this indifference curve choice picture to the same type of idea in a demand curve, price of X against good X type of picture. So we're going to do a bit of both. Let me now increase the price of X so we can see what's going to happen here. And I'm going to do a substantial increase, so there's a little bit of a change. And let's make it bigger so we can actually see what's going on. So there's a bigger change, and I'm going to still make it even bigger. Okay, so here's the original indifference curve, and this is the new indifference curve, the new budget line after the price of X has increased. This dash blue line is parallel to the new budget line but tangent to the old indifference curve. The movement from here to here is the substitution effect, and this set of diamonds from here to here is the amount that income would need to go up at the old at the new prices to get you to the old indifference curve. So this height is the compensating variation. Here is the new choice point after the price of X has increased without any compensation. And this is a point on the new indifference curve that has the same relative price as the original point. So going from here to here is like a decrease in income at the new prices. And this black dark bar, that height represents the equivalent variation. That's the amount of income you can take away from the consumer to get them to the new indifference curve at the original prices. This height need not equal this height, and indeed in this case the compensating variation is bigger than the equivalent variation. I want to note here that good X and good Y in this picture are both normal goods, and that partly explains it. So now we want to go over to the other picture and take a look at what's happening here. This red indifference curve, red demand curve here is the compensating demand curve for the original indifference curve. Let me move it even further here so you can see the whole picture. And it measures just the substitution effect along the original indifference curve. This orange demand curve here measures the substitution effect along the new indifference curve. The area between the original price and the new price to the left of the orange curve is the equivalent variation. The area to the left of the red curve between the original price and the new price is the compensating variation. So the compensating variation is bigger here. This blue demand curve, which is more elastic than either the red or the orange curve at the places where it crosses it, is the ordinary demand curve, and it's more elastic because the good in question is normal. The area between here and here is the change in consumer surplus as a consequence of the price change. So that change in consumer surplus has a lower bound in this case because of its normal of the equivalent variation and an upper bound of the compensating variation. So there you have it.